Hello students, we will study the second part of the diagrams and graphs. In the first part or in your first video, we have come across what do we mean by diagrams and what are the rules which we have to follow while drawing or constructing the diagrams. Now we will study different types of diagrams. Now before we go for it, you should have the idea that diagrams are of many types. Broadly they are classified into two. The first one is one dimensional bar diagram and the second one is two dimensional bar diagram. Now the question arises, what do we mean by one dimensional bar diagram? So in this type of bar diagram, here bar we are going to represent it in a form of a rectangle, and many of the authors have taken it as bars or line, but here we will be preferring a rectangle and not a line. Now, so a bar is a rectangle. One dimensional, what we do is here, we are going to study or we are going to represent in the diagram only the length. That is, here you are going to take the height according to the figure of the variables. Illa variables andre neevu data kottirthara. Variables may be regarding to production, sales, imports, exports, profit, etc. of different years. Illi en maartivi naavu one variable study maartivi. Aamale aa variable naavu en maartivi different periods ge athwa different years ge study maartirtive. So in the diagram what we are going to represent is, we are going to represent only the length of the bar. That is, the variable length is taken into consideration and the width remains the same for all the bars. In one dimensional bar diagram, what is going to happen is, we are going to study only the length, whereas the width will remain the same. This is your diagram. Take into account. So here what is going to happen is, we are going to decide or we are going to measure only the length ethroge one dimensional age. Aamale width en irutte, the width of all bars will be the same and the gap between the bars will also be same. So such type of bar diagrams are called as one dimensional bar diagram. One dimensional means here when we are studying the variable or when we are going to present the variable in the diagram, only the length is taken according to the figures given in the problem, whereas the width of all bars will remain same. Aamale illa width ellathrigu same irthava. Mattondu gap between the bars, ee bar in between gap en irutte uniform irutte andre same irutte. So such types of diagrams are called as one dimensional bar diagram. And in case of two dimensional bar diagram, what is going to happen is, here we are going to represent both the length and the width of the bar. So illi en maartivi naavu length anno amale aa particular bar the width anno naavu present maartivi. In that case en aagutte, ella bar do width anno same iralla, even height anno vary aagabodu. So two dimensional bar diagrams we are going to measure both the length and the width of the bar. Now, before we go for two dimensional in detail, first we will study what types of bar diagrams you are going to study under the heading one dimensional bar diagram. So one dimensional bar diagram, so here they are simple bar diagram, multiple bar diagram, subdivided bar diagram and percentage bar diagram. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಡ್ರಿ, ನೀವು ಇವು ನಾಲ್ಕು ಟೈಪು ಒಂದೊಂದಂತೆ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ? ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್. ನಾ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಬಾರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಬಾರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್. ಇಲ್ಲೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್ variable, for example like imports, exports, then profit, loss, or what you call again sales, production. One variable study martira, amale aa variable you will be studying for different years. For example, production of ABC company for the year 2000 to 2005. So ಇಲ್ಲೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಒಂದ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ 5 years, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ 2000 to 2005 ಮಟ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಬಾರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಇಯರ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಲೇಮ್ representing it. Here what we do is, we will be taking into account the, as it is one dimensional, only the height of the bars, that is the length of the bar is being studied, whereas the width remain the same and the gap between the bars will also be uniform or same. Now the question, next question is, how the bars will be represented? Now you can represent the bar vertically and even horizontally. You vertical like represent madabodu athwa horizontal like. Vertical form mulage how it will be like this. On OX axis you will be representing, OX axis mega the represent aagutte first bar, the second one, third one, fourth one, like this. You can present in the vertical form. And as I have told you that the width of the bars will be the same and the gap between the bars will also be the same. Only thing what changes is the length. Length hai change agutte nim figures mega. So you can present vertically or even horizontally. Horizontally means you will be presenting it on Y axis. Il you represent martirthira. So it may be like this also. One, two, three, four. So in this way also it can be presented. But we prefer vertical, not horizontal. Idu one point. Then, when you are presenting it in the diagram, you can even color the bars or shade the bars so that the diagram becomes more attractive. That point can also be taken into account. And once you have presented it, the data in the diagram, you have to write the scale. What in, is the scale you have taken on OX axis and OY axis. So in simple bar diagram, what we will be studying is one variable for different periods. And bars can be presented horizontally or vertically, but we prefer vertical. Then you have to write the scale. Afterwards, you can color or shade the bars so that the diagram becomes more attractive. So one example, I will solve on simple bar diagram. So each variable, that only variable which you will be studying, will be presented in the bar. So the example is, here what we will do is, we will be taking into account the brushes. It is the example from your book. So a survey was conducted to find out the type of toothbrush on 1000 people gave the following information. So here what has been done is, a survey was conducted where on 1000 respondents were contacted, so to find out what type of brushes they are using. So illenide types of brushes.
Y
one unit, okay? So here one unit, this is one unit. Is equal to type of brush. Then OI axis in one unit and length. So the scale here totally how many are there? 1000 people are there. And look at the given figures, accordingly you decide your scale. So I will be checking here as 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 800, 900, 1000. So the scale will totally depend upon the space available. So here one unit is equal to 100. So look at the gap, we have kept the gap of 100, so 100 people. So once this is done, now you represent a data. The first one, hard brush. How many of them are using? 300. So first, leave the gap of one unit. Then you go for the second unit. What will be the length? It is 300. So 300 will be represented. We'll be taking one bar. So this is your 300 half. Then once this is done, go for the second one, medium. How many people are using medium? 500. So put a bar for 500. Look at both OX axis and OY axis. So the width will remain the same for all the bars as it is your one dimensional bar diagram. The one dimensional bar diagram is width the same, only the length change. So medium 500. So 500. Use a scale and dot the bar. So 500, that is your median. Then lastly, soft. How many people are using soft? 200. So this is soft. More attractive, you can shade different type or even you can color them. It is totally left to you people. So even your index model is very good. So what it shows? Arm. Then the second, it shows median, and the last one represents soft. So this is your index. This is how the simple bar diagram is represented. So simple bar diagram one variable study. Here we are studying the variable brushes, and it is for different periods. Years different people the only way. Here we will be taking into account the length of the bar, the width of the bar remain the same, whereas the gap between the bar should be uniform. Scale, you have to write it. OX axis magnitude represent quantity 1 unit and the estro. Adhe thara OY axis magnitude represent quantity ಅದರ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಏನಿದೆ. ದೆನ್ ಯು ಡ್ರಾ ದಿ ಬಾರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ವಿ ಪ್ರಿಫರ್ ವರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಬಾರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹಾರಿಜೆಂಟಲ್ ಬಾರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಬಾರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಈಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಯು. ಬಟ್ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಸಬ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬಾರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಆರ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಬಾರ್ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಯು ಹೌ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್. ಇಲ್ಲೇ ನಾವು ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ಬರೆದಿದ್ದು ನಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ. ಆದರೆ ನೀವು ಮುಂದೆ ಏನು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರೋ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸು ಪ್ರಿಫರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಡ್ರಾ ದ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪೆನ್ಸಿಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಜಾಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಎವರ್ ಆರ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ. ನಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಜಾಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡ್ರಾ ದಿ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್ attractive and beautiful. So this is your simple bar diagram and in many videos I have made the point very clear for you. Books are there in the library, collect the books from the library and you can practice the problems and it becomes easy for you people to when you are appearing for the examination. And do remember when you are presenting the diagram, don't forget to write the title and your title should be short, precise and clear. Thank you.